Can you see?
Sharpen up my tools. It's all blunted from that hitting the back of the stern.
There you go.
Actually, this is my gaff. I'm gonna get it to you. Like my little jig?
Yeah, yeah, that works good. That's gonna be real pokey.
Yeah. I'll put a few more holes in the gel coat with it. Pretty good at that.
At least it won't bounce off the out of the
yeah.
Fish.
Yeah.
Pick your teeth with that.
How about yours? Are you sharpening yours?
No, but Dad is.
Oh, that's sharp.
Yeah, actually, it's okay.
What about the small ones? Are they good?
Yeah, it's for shaking fish.
Oh, okay.
Hey everyone, this is Matt. I just want to pop in for a minute and let you all know that this is footage from back in June. I didn't have a chance to put it together before our Juneau trip, so it's a bit delayed. I know there are a lot of people that were eagerly awaiting the follow-up video to the setting out of the halibut set, so thanks for being patient. We'll be putting out some catch-up fishing videos here for the next few weeks, so look forward to that. And until then, enjoy the video. Be sure to like, comment, and subscribe, and we'll see you again soon.
Here we go.
It's not loud.
What do you say? Can you hear?
Ready to rumble, maybe?
Your feet, T.
Thank you.
pocket. I'm sorry, love.
Hey, maybe your sunglasses are in there too.
I wish. Sorry, T. Guess I'll come back here with you guys, huh?
So most guys haul from the starboard side or the port side, but midships, we haul off the stern just because it's easy, I guess. At one time we didn't have throttle and steering back here, and so it was actually pretty easy to pull off the stern. That reel just pulled the boat backwards. So the reason I'm bumping it into gear once in a while is because tide's actually running this way. We're drifting down on the gear, so I'm just giving a little bump once in a while, and that keeps us in front of us. Keeps it, well, behind us, but keeps us in front of it. You can see that we're slowly creeping up on it. We'll run over it if I don't. And it's nice if you can just pull with the current. It's really easy. You don't have to work the boat much, and gear comes up nice. You're not pulling the fish against the current. One of these days we might switch over to the midships, but for now, this is where we're at. It works well. The only thing you have to really be careful of is not to get that line in the wheel. And usually that just happens if you get a big snarl coming up. Quarter of it comes in kind of slow. Then as we start to get some line built up on the reel, it goes faster and faster. What's that I see? What is it, codfish?
sometimes they start out slow. We don't know. Fishing's fishing.
Yeah, you gotta start somewhere.
Yep.
I'll put gear in the water to see if there's anything there.
Yeah.
Something come along before too long. Ah, monkfish.
Ah, is that what they call them?
That's what everybody thinks. Those are monkfish.
No.
These aren't monkfish, guys. Those are Atlantic Ocean, not Pacific Ocean.
Must look a lot of like. Are they this? Do you think they're bullhead too, or?
I don't know if they're part of the sculpin family or not. They do look similar, but they're like a lot flatter.
Uh-huh.
There we go. Oh, something glowy. Codfish. Fish sculpin skates. It's all here. Halibut always like hanging out with these guys.
Yeah.
Nice halibut like to hang out. So hopefully we see something. It's like 15 hooks. So. We got a little ways to go still. There's a halibut. And that's a nice one too.
Getting some, huh?
There's life.
Yeah.
I was gonna say, he looks kind of meaty, huh? nice.
It's gotten even better.
Tempted to put it back down, but also I don't know. I mean, we just need to pull it too, so become something. Something, something.
Oh, that's fun.
Yeah. Small.
Small but fat.
Yeah. Catching one, but not very good for eating.
Yeah.
It's like eating a tough old bull or something.
Tough old what?
Bull.
Yeah.
Leave them out there for breeding stock. Plus, they're always females, the big fish. Leave
oh,
them
yeah.
out there to procreate.
Yeah, you want to leave those there, huh? How you doing, Tristan? Good? Just manning your station, huh?
Oh, you want to come run the rail? Are you enthusiastic?
Yeah. People always say you look pretty bored, but I mean, it's not exactly a thrilling job to pin hooks.
No, not really. Mom agrees.
He's not going to be hopping up and down with joy for every hook he gets.
I think people fail to realize that most of fishing is actually pretty boring and menial, repetitious. Yeah. Get excited about good catches and good hauls. And
yeah. But otherwise, it's just...
But the work is just work. It's
in between fish, you're just going through the motions.
Yep. Just enjoying it.
Yeah.
Chilling out. The yellow eye.
Oh, yellow eye.
And another yellow eye down there. You can always tell a long ways away.
And that, what is that? Their air bladders sticking out?
Yep. another. Go mark your spot, please.
I'll get a picture of that one, Matt.
Yeah, his eyes are here. Oh, put that peanut away.
Pretty, pretty.
Did it mark? Thank you.
Yeah, we've had some customers or some of our people ask about yellow eye. They're waiting, hun.
Yeah. Yellow eye is yummy.
It is. One of our favorites.
Oh.
Going first. Not that that really makes a big difference. Going down there.
Lots of different tracks.
getting close to that anchor.
Yeah, I think we might have just picked it up.
Oh.
Could have been better, could have been worse.
It's a start, right?
Yep.
Finally, huh? After the anchor got pulled, they pop up?
No, no, they've been up for a while.
Oh, have they?
About three. We spotted them like 3 times ago.
About what?
About 3 ago.
Oh.
Yeah. Seen them for a while now. They weren't down.
They were hiding.
I think our count was off. Somebody's count. Can't do it. I can't keep track.
Ankles off, huh?
Yeah, must be that.
Get there, get it.
anything to say, guys?
Nope.
Okay.
So we'll clean these fish up and
head to the next.
Another set.
Yep.
All right, so we'll get cleaning these halibut here. sitting down.
Point.